morning. Welcome to the Veteran Affairs Showcase. I'm Liz Graybill, Berks County Department of Veteran Affairs, and I am the program Community Relations Program Manager for the department. On this showcase, we highlight veterans' benefits and services, and today's show is on the meaning of Memorial Day and our personal perspective. Toward the end of the show, I will provide you with several Memorial Day parades that will be taking place in Berks County. So please get a pen and paper so you can write down those dates, times, and locations of parades. With me today is Dennis Damiani, Air Force veteran, and he works with teachers at Thomas Ford Learning Academy, and Kevin Focht, former battalion commander, Wilson JROTC, and now a Norwich University student and corporal in the Corps Cadet with Marine Corps option. Callers, the number to call in on is 610-378-0426. Prior to Memorial Day each year, our office distributes flags to volunteers to place the flags on the grave sites of all the Berks County veterans' graves. On behalf of the Berks County Department of Veteran Affairs, we want to say thank you to all those 300-plus volunteers that make this happen every year. Without each of you, we would not be able to place flags in the 217 cemeteries in Berks County on all the veterans' graves. Thank you. Memorial Day was originally known as Decoration Day because it was a time to honor the nation's dead by decorating their graves with flowers. Now it is known as Memorial Day and is a day of remembrance for those who have died in our nation's service. Memorial Day is a day where we actively remember our ancestors, family members, loved ones, neighbors, and friends who gave the ultimate sacrifice defending our great nation. Memorial Day is about coming together to honor those who gave their all. Traditional observation of Memorial Day has diminished over the years and could be lost if we as a community do not share in remembering the meaning and traditions of Memorial Day. Many Americans nowadays have forgotten the meaning and traditions of Memorial Day. At many cemeteries, the graves of the fallen are increasingly ignored and neglected. Memorial Day is for remembrance, and Veterans Day is for celebrating all those who served in the military. This Memorial Day and every Memorial Day, please take time to honor those who made the ultimate sacrifice in defense of our great nation. You and your families can do that by flying the U.S. flag at half staff until noon. In the morning, the flag should be raised momentarily to the top, then lowered to half staff. Before lowering the flag for the day, raise the flag again to the top for a moment, then lower the flag as normal. Americans can also honor prisoners of war and those missing in action by flying the POW MIA flag. You can visit cemeteries and grave sites and placing flags or flowers on the graves of our fallen heroes. Visit memorials and read about the memorials around the country. You can participate in a national moment of remembrance that is at 3 p.m. local time on Memorial Day, no matter where you are. Pause for a moment of silence and think upon the true meaning of the day. Remember and honor the fallen or listen to taps being played. Memorial Day was created as an occasion to honor those who have paid the ultimate price to ensure our freedom. It is our opportunity to stop and give thanks for the many who have died protecting that freedom. Memorial Day is a perfect opportunity for families to read their family history, especially of those who died in the line of battle. It is also an occasion for reading Lincoln's Gettysburg Address. Memorial Day is renewing a pledge to aid the widows, widowers, and orphans of our fallen dead and to aid the disabled veterans. At this time, Dennis Damiani is going to talk to us about what Memorial Day means to him.
Well, Memorial Day for me is very important. My father was in the Air Force. He served. And I served for 4 years, And I love my country. I love history. And where I work now at the Thomas Ford Learning Academy, we have a routine every day where our kids take the put the flag up and take the flag down. And our kids are jockeying every day to take that flag down and fold it. And I thought it would be a great opportunity for our students to learn the real meaning of Memorial Day. So what we did at the Academy is we organized a field trip 2 years ago. And the field trip was to go to the City Park, the First Defenders Monument. And our second stop was the General Gregg statue on Center Avenue. And our third stop was the Charles Evans Cemetery. Our first stop at the First Defenders statue, our students took down notes. They looked at the plaque. We told them the history about the First Defenders and the importance of it. And they were excited about it. We went to our second stop at the General Gregg statue. General Gregg was a hero at Gettysburg. He was a cavalry officer who later lived his life in Reading. And the kids, once again, took notes there at the plaques, and we were able to teach them things about the Civil War. Our last stop that day was the Charles Evans Cemetery to visit the Civil War monument up there and the Civil War graves. And our students from the Academy did like etchings of the stones, and we put them in our school, and we held them up in our school, and the kids were able to see who these men were. And it was such a great success, this trip, that I thought we could do another trip about Memorial Day and putting flags up. And our kids are mostly eighth graders and some seventh graders. So yesterday we took our kids back to Charles Evans Cemetery, and with our bus, we parked up there. We got, I guess, there were maybe three boxes of flags. And I told our students what to do. We all went out together. I showed them what they were going to do. And once they got the hang of it and they knew what they were going to do, they got so excited about putting these flags up. And they would call me over and say, "What does this mean here?" And I would tell them, "This person served in the World War II, World War I, and Spanish-American War." And they were able to connect the flag to what they were doing. And it was exciting because they all really wanted to do this job. And they scattered, and they were putting flags in all these graves, and it was a great learning experience for these kids. And that's how you teach kids. Kids have to learn by doing, not just reading. If they can do something and connect, you make an impression on their minds and their hearts and their lives, and you can change these kids around. You can make them better citizens, model citizens. And that's the goal of all education. That's the goal at the Academy. We want to help these kids learn. And it was great because at the end of the day, we were going home, our students, they wanted me to give them, they want to take a flag home, put a flag in their front yard. So I know we had a successful trip. And I was proud of them. I was really proud of them. Also, you know, there is at our church, at Holy Guardian Angels, we have a cemetery there. It's called Gethsemane. And in Gethsemane Cemetery is buried a soldier by the name of Joe Toy. Joe Toy was in Band of Brothers. And the story of Joe is that he won, I think, the Silver Star, the Bronze Star, and he won four Purple Hearts. And the last Purple Heart that he received because he lost his leg at the Battle of the Bulge. When he came back to the States through Atlantic City, he ended up in Reading. And he lived in Reading. And he had a job at Grace Mines as a grinder for 30 years. And he had three kids. And his children never knew the extent of what their father did in the war. He never talked about it. But when he passed away, they found a box of medals and Purple Hearts, and they were amazed at what their father did. And that generation back then was like that. They were humble. They just had a job, and they just did it. It's just a remarkable generation that they were. And I look up to them all the time. And as I said, he's buried out there at Gethsemane. And our future trip out there for next year is to take the kids there to tell them the story of Joe Toy, to see what he did and who he was. And that's just how you connect with kids. They want to learn. They want to see these things.
That's great, Dennis, that they're getting out of the classroom and actually placing flags and going to cemeteries and learning the history right there. That's really good. And also with me today is Kevin Focht. And Kevin's going to tell us his Memorial Day perspective.
One thing that's critical that Dennis brought up is, you know, we got to invest in our youth. It's so critical that we Involve the youth in these activities and veteran activities. Being young myself, being only 19, it's critical that we get young people involved. And I had the distinct privilege 2 days ago to go to be invited back to go with the Wilson Junior RTC to go place flags at Pleasant View Cemetery, similar to what Dennis and his kids did. And it was just a privilege to go out there and place flags. But one thing that's starting to occur, and Liz mentioned this earlier, was Memorial Day is becoming more and more of a holiday rather than honoring the sacrifices that our military have made. And the sacrifice has been made since the Revolution and all the way out to the present day. Now, whether you agree with some of the wars that are going on or not, it's so critical that we still continue to honor that sacrifice that is made by our troops all around the world for freedom and for the greater good of the world. And I had the distinct privilege of going to Arlington National Cemetery. Now, if you've been to Arlington National Cemetery, it's a sight to behold, because all you can see is rolling hills and white marble stones, and each one has a service member that was either served honorably or was killed in action. And just to see how many are buried there is an incredible privilege. And one thing that I think Arlington National Cemetery captivates is that Memorial Day isn't just one day of the year, it's every day. And we got to continue to support our veterans every day. And I had a distinct privilege. I guess we're going to go on break here, and we'll be back after the break. And we'll continue on Normandy Cemetery. Thank you.
You're watching Veterans Affairs Showcase on bctv.org. Be informed. Be involved. Be a member. For membership information, go to bctv.org. For more information about your community and how to become involved in your community, go to bctv.org.
Good morning. Welcome back to the Veteran Affairs Showcase. I'm Liz Graybill. With me today we have Dennis Damiani and Kevin Focht, and we're talking about Memorial Day and our perspective on Memorial Day. And I will be telling you about the upcoming Memorial Day parade, so please get a pen and paper so you can take notes when those are. I want to tell you a few more things about Memorial Day before I release it back to Kevin. Memorial Day poppies was inspired by the poem In Flanders Fields as an emblem for keeping the faith with all who died. The poppy is a universal symbol of tribute and support for veterans. At this time, I'm going to read In Flanders Field. It's a little short poem. In Flanders Fields, the poppies blow between the crosses row on row that mark our place, and in the sky, the larks still bravely singing fly scarce heard amid the guns below. We are the dead. Short days ago we lived, felt down, saw sunset glow, loved and were loved, and now we lie in Flanders Fields. Take up your quarrel with the foe. To you from failing hands we throw the torch. Be yours to hold it high. If ye break faith with us who die, we shall not sleep, though poppies grow in Flanders Field. And today with me I have a few poppies, and I just want to give my guest one to wear today and on Memorial Day. Okay, we will now continue with Kevin Focht telling us his story on Memorial Day. Perspective.
Okay, before the break, is I was talking about the significance of Memorial Day and how it should be every day and not just one day. And I had a distinct privilege of going to Arlington as well as Normandy Cemetery over in France. And Dennis's nephew was actually my history teacher that got this trip together, and we went over and all around the cemetery, you just see white marble crosses and Stars of David as far as you can see. And it's just incredible. And if that's not moving, one of the groundskeepers mentioned, one of the quotes that he said was, "This might be on French soil, but these beaches, this cemetery was paid and bought for by American blood." And I didn't, that really inspired me, because, you know, it just shows the sacrifice that our troops not only make for our freedom, but as well as the freedom of all over the world. In that case, you know, liberating France. So it was just critical to see the respect still shown by other countries for the sacrifices made by our military.
You know, Liz, and getting back to Kevin, what Kevin just said, Kevin, you know, is a good example of how a young student can be excited about learning about his country, and now he serves for his country. Because, like he said, my nephew, Mr. Damiani, Dean Damiani at Wilson, is a history teacher. I mean, Dean was young. I took Dean and his brother to Gettysburg when they were real young, and we showed them Little Round Top, and we showed them, you know, Pickett's Charge and those areas of the battlefield, and they became excited about it, and they liked it, and their interest was engendered, and they began to think, you know, along those lines of wanting to learn more. And they became, Dean became a great student of history, and he's a real knowledgeable kid. As he said, he devised these trips for the kids at Wilson, and it just shows you, if you can get a young student involved in history, to learn history, they can change someone else's life down the road. And I'm really proud that I met Kevin today. We just talked about this before the show. I didn't know Kevin was one of Dean's students. So I was really impressed by that. And I'm thankful. I'm thankful for our country and the people we have who teach history and want our students to learn, because we just have to keep pushing it. Because if we don't push it, they're going to forget it. And if you're excited about something, they'll be excited about it. But if you're not excited about it, it's going to be boring for any subject. So liking history in the military like we do, we're gonna teach it, make it live.
Kevin, can you tell us about the Wilson Alumni Fallen Project you did?
Absolutely, Liz. The Wilson High School Fallen Alumni Project was a project that myself and Lieutenant Colonel Wendell May, the senior Army instructor of Wilson Junior ROTC, conceived in 2009. It was one of the projects that was an Eagle. It started out as an Eagle Scout project, and it took about all my high school career, because at the time I was a freshman, and it took me all over the world. And I even got to see one of the Wilson High School fallen alumni in Normandy Cemetery, his grave, and another one is listed on the wall there. It was just an incredible experience, and we had the distinct privilege to build a flag case and host a memorial service, which we had, we flew in Gold Star mothers of Wilson alumni that were killed in action to come to the Wilson High School memorial service for the fallen alumni, which happened in the spring of 2012. And it just goes to show that every school needs to recognize their fallen alumni. And, you know, just the amount of respect that our students show for, you know, those who made the great sacrifice. And sometimes it falls under the radar in our schools. And I feel like if every school recognized their fallen alumni and those who served, you would have more youth involvement in veterans' activities, as Dennis was mentioning earlier. And one of the statements, one of our mission statements at Norwich is to give our youth an education that shall be American in character. That's the opening statement, and it just shows how, it's important to stress that we, influence our youth to take pride in their country and to, down the road maybe help out, as Dennis was saying, because it pays forward, you know. One day I might, share it on to our youth and our kids, and, in turn they'll go and share it on to their kids or youth around the area. So it definitely pays forward, and I see it every day.
Thank you, Kevin and Dennis. You can see that it's very important that we do not lose sight of what the real meaning of Memorial Day is, and you heard our different perspectives. There are several Memorial Day parades in the local communities. Please attend one or several if you're able to come out to remember with pride those who sacrificed so much for our country. At this time, I would like to go to the document viewer, please, and show you a list of all the upcoming parades in the next few days. Oh, it's very hard to read. Okay, Saturday, May 25th, Why Missing Memorial Day Parade is at 9:45. It starts near the Why Missing Hills Memorial Park and ends at the park for a service there. On Sunday, May 26th, Womelsdorf VFW, they begin with the church service at St. Daniel's. Everyone is invited back to the post for a light lunch and then to the park at 1:30 for a ceremony and then to the cemetery. Reamstown Community Memorial Day service on Sunday, May 26th is at 4 p.m. at the Reamstown Memorial Park. Ole Valley Memorial Parade and Ceremony is at 6 p.m. on Sunday, May 26th and starts on Main Street to Freedom Cemetery. Monday, Memorial Day, May 27th, Kutztown Memorial Day Parade is at 8:30 at the Kutztown Fairgrounds and goes to the Fairview Cemetery and Hope Cemetery for services. A service will be at Moton VFW at 8:45 on Monday. Then the Moton Parade begins at 9, starting at the Moton VFW. Birdsboro Memorial Day Parade is at 9 a.m. West 1st and Monroe Streets to Birdsboro Cemetery for services. The Berks County Memorial Day Ceremony is at Veterans Grove in Redding City Park, and that begins at 9 a.m. on Monday. Exeter Township has a Memorial Day Parade beginning at 9 a.m. at the Exeter High School, ending at Forest Hills Memorial Park for services from 10:30 to 11. Fleetwood Memorial Day Parade is at 9 a.m. at the Community Center to Fleetwood Cemetery for a service, continues to St. Paul's Union Cemetery for another service, and ends at the Community Park for a service about 10 a.m. Warnersville Parade begins at 9 a.m. on Monday, May 27th. Boyertown Memorial Day Parade is at 9:15, begins at Monroe Street to Boyer's Corner Cemetery for a cemetery ceremony, and then to Fairview Cemetery for services. The Berks County Memorial Day Ceremony at Charles Evans Cemetery begins at 10:30 a.m. Shillington Memorial Day Parade is at 10:30, and it's from the Governor Mifflin Middle School parking lot to Fairview Cemetery for a service. Burnville Parade begins at 2 p.m. on Monday the 27th from the Penn Burnville Elementary School. Memorial Day service, 3 p.m. at the Bellman's Church at Bellman's Church Road in Mooresville. Thank you, Dennis and Kevin, for coming out today. It's been very good. For playback, you can find this show and a whole lot more at bctv.org. And thank you, guys. It's been a pleasure having you here, hearing your stories. Thank you, audience, for watching the Veteran Affairs Showcase. Our show is aired live here at BCTV at 10 a.m. on the fourth Friday of each month. Thank you. Goodbye.